What we are going to do now is take a neat little virtual tour through the main components of any business school curriculum. Just why are we doing this in a course in economics? To put it simply, it's an exercise in, let's look at the business education forest before we get lost amongst the individual course trees. And my broader goal here is to show you how the many and varied insights and tools of economics provide the essential glue that binds these pieces of the business education puzzle together. For example, when we work our way through consumer theory and microeconomics, you will quickly see that the tools of supply and demand and concepts like price elasticities can certainly help marketing executives figure out how to profitably price and position a firm's products. At the same time, the insights and models of production theory provide a mighty boost to any firm's operations management team seeking to produce the firm's products at the lowest possible cost. But it's not just microeconomics that is so valuable in running an enterprise. A solid grounding in macroeconomic principles and business forecasting can also help executives more profitably manage the organization over the course of the ups and downs of the business cycle. Here, although it may seem counterintuitive, recessions can be a great time for firms to increase their advertising and capital investment so as to be ready for the next profitable economic expansion. Yet far too often, penny-pinching firms do just the opposite in recessions and lose great profit opportunities. At any rate, that's the big picture.